Hello everyone, welcome again to my mathematics class. So today we will start with the fourth quarter. Chapter natin is about trigonometry. So ang lesson number one natin will be about Pythagorean theorem. How to find the missing side of a right triangle. So ang mga related concept natin na gagamitin dito, yung mga perfect squares, and then yung mga square root ng number, mapa-rational man and irrational. Okay, so simulan natin sa concept ng Pythagorean theorem. Pythagorean theorem says that in a right triangle, the square of the longest side, which is called the hypotenuse, is equal to the sum of the squares of the two legs. Consider natin itong triangle ABC or ACB as our right triangle. Okay, so opposite the 90 degree here, or the right angle, is the hypotenuse. Okay, so ito yung angle A natin. Consider natin itong angle A na to. So yung opposite side niya, let's call it side A. And then yung opposite side naman ng angle B, let's call it side B. Normally they are called legs. So, sa problem solving, sometimes itong side A na to are called height or altitude. While yung side B naman, or yung AC, sometimes it's called the base. Ito ang ating hypotenuse. Kung saan, siya yung side na opposite ng right angle. Okay, so let's name it as side C or the hypotenuse C. Okay, so according to the Pythagorean theorem, in a right triangle daw, the square of the longest side, which is the hypotenuse, is equal to the sum of the squares of the two legs. Okay, so ang mabubuo nating equation dyan, according to the theorem, is C squared is equal to the sum of the squares of the two legs. Okay, so kung hahanapin mo yung length ng C na yan, ng side C, square root principle, remember, para mawala yung square niyan, you take the square of the other side. So, ang magiging formula mo para mahanap mo yung side C will be square root of A squared plus B squared. So, kunin mo yung square, tapos ng bawat isa, tapos add mo, tapos kunin mo yung square root niya. Yun yung side C natin, or the hypotenuse. Similarly, kung A naman ang missing, transpose mo yung B squared to the other side, so magiging A squared is equal to C squared minus B squared. Okay, so ang formula mo ngayon for A, para mawala yung square niyan, you take the square of the other side, square root principle, so magiging A is equal to the square root of C squared minus B squared. Okay, so ganun din sa B naman, kung B ang missing, i-transpose mo yung A squared to the other side. Okay, so magiging B squared is equal to C squared minus A squared. So, ang formula mo ngayon para mahanap mo yung length ng side B will be B is equal to the square root of C squared minus A squared. Okay, so laging tatandaan yung Pythagorean theorem. Ito na siya. The square of the longest side is equal to the sum of the squares of the two legs. Okay, so let us have some examples na maganap tayo ng mga missing sides. Okay, so let us have example number one here. So, we have here a right triangle. Ito ang right angle natin. Therefore, yung C ang hypotenuse. So, yung 3 is a leg and yung 4 is also a leg. Applying the Pythagorean theorem, para mahanap natin yung C, C is equal to the square root of the sum of the squares of the legs. Okay, so we have 3 squared plus 4 squared. Okay, so tuloy pa natin ang pagsasolve. So C now is equal to the square root of 3 squared is equal to 9, and then yung 4 squared is equal to 16. Add muna natin. So C now is equal to the square root of 25. 25 is a perfect square. So, C now will be equal to square root ng 25 is 5. Okay, so baksan natin. This is the answer for number 1. Our hypotenuse is 5. Okay, so punta tayo sa example number Number 2. Okay, so ito ang right angle natin. Therefore, yung 17 na yan is the hypotenuse. Okay, so a leg ang missing dito. So, represented by variable x. Para mahanap yung x na yan, so we have x squared is equal to 17 squared minus 15 squared. Right? So, yan yung Pythagorean theorem natin. So, di ba pagka leg ang missing, i-minus mo siya sa squared ng hypotenuse. So, para mawala yung squared, you take the square root of the other side. So, x na will be equal to the square root of 17 squared minus 15 squared. Okay? Ano ba yung 17 squared? That is 289, I think. So, kaya kailangan alam natin yung mga perfect square natin, no? So, this is 289. Then, yung 15 squared naman, 15 times 15 is 225. Okay? So, bago kunin ng square root, i-minus mo muna yung 218, yung 225 sa 289, and that will be 64. So, 64 is a perfect square. Makukuha mo agad yung square root niyan. So, x now will be equal to 8. This is now our answer. Okay, so, value ng x, length niya, is equal to 8. Okay, so, let's go to another example. Let's go to example number 3. So, ito ang right angle. Therefore, yung opposite side is the hypotenuse. So, ang missing dito will be a leg. Leg x ulit. Okay, so solution. Solve natin. Apply natin yung mga formula na sa Pythagorean theorem. Leg ang missing. So, x squared is equal to 13 squared minus 12 squared. Ito yung hypotenuse. So, kapag leg, laging sinusubtract yun sa squared ng hypotenuse. Okay, so x now will be equal to the square root of 13 squared minus 12 squared. Okay, so ang square ng 13 is 169. 13 squared is 169 minus 144, which is the square of 12. Okay, so x now will be equal to 169 minus 144 is 25. Right? So, x now will be equal to 5. So, this is now our answer. So, number 3. X is equal to 5. Okay? So, let us have more examples. Okay? So, example number 4. We have here another right triangle. Ito ang hypotenuse. Ito ang right angle natin. Therefore, yung opposite side niya is the hypotenuse. So, yun si ang hypotenuse natin dito. So, may given tayong length ng leg, 2 square root of 5, tapos yung isa naman ay 5. So, gawa tayo ng formula para sa hypotenuse natin. So, C squared is equal to the square of these two legs. So, 2 square root of 5 squared, tapos 5 squared. Okay, so, para mawala yun, you take the square root of the other side. So, C is equal to the square root of 2 square root of 5 squared plus 5 squared muna. Okay? Okay, so, simplifying more. 2 squared is equal to 4. Right? And then, meron tayong, di ba, nung nasa radicals tayo, this is the square root of 5 squared is the same as 5. Kasi, di ba, pag nirational mo siya, it will be just, ito, ang index na ito ay 2. So, 2, 5 raised to 2 over 2. So, magiging 1 na, equals to 5 na lang. Okay, so, this square root of 5 squared is equal to 5. And then, yung 5 squared naman is equal to 25. 5 times 5 is 25. Simplifying more, we have C is equal to the square root of 20 plus 25, and that will be 45. So, C now is equal to the square root of 45. So, hanapan mo siya ng perfect square para masimplify natin. Diba, mga perfect square, 1, 4, 9, 16, 25. So, kung may factor pa yung 45 na perfect square, I think is 9. Para ma-simplify mo pa. So, C is equal to the square root of 9 times 5. That is 45, diba? So, C now, diba ang square root ng 9 ay 3. So, ang C mo, ang length ng C ngayon will be square root ng 9 ay 3. Square root ng 9 ay 3. Tapos, may iiwan sa loob ng radical symbol, yung square root of 5. So, eto na ngayon ang length ng ating hypotenuse. This will be 3 square root of 5. Okay, so, laging tatandaan yung mga perfect square na yan para ma-simplify mo kung ano man yung radicand natin na mayroong perfect square. Okay? So, let us have last example. Okay, so, example number 5, our last example. I have here another right triangle. Ito yung right angle natin, 90 degrees. Opposite niya is the hypotenuse. Missing is leg A. Okay, given yung leg na to, which is square root of 3 over 2. So, gawin natin ang formula yung leg na to. So, A squared is equal to, ito yung hypotenuse natin. So, 1 squared minus square root of 3 over 2 squared. Okay? Simplifying more, so para mawala yung square natin, you take the square root of the other side. So, A now will be equal to the square root of 1 squared minus square root of 3 over 2 squared. Okay, simplify pa natin. So, A now, ang 1 squared is the same as 1. 1 times 1 is still 1. So, yung square root of 3, di ba, meron tayong quotient property of square root. Diniscuss natin nung nasa radicals. Wherein, yung square root of 3 over 2 na naka-squared can be written as square root of 3 squared tapos 2 squared. Okay, so, eto magiging 3 na lang. And then, yung denominator will be 4. So, this is the same as square root of 1 minus 3/4. Okay, so gawin mong similar fraction tong dalawa. Yung 1 can be written also as 4 over 4. So A now will be equal to square root of 4 over 4 minus 3/4 para ma-minus mo yung 3/4 sa 1. Okay, so similar fraction na sila. Subtract mo na numerator, so square root of 1/4. Square root ng 1 is still 1. Square root ng 4 ay 2. So, A now will be equal to 1/2. So, paano nangyari yun? So, use again the quotient property of square root. Pwede mo siyang pag-iwalayin. Square root of 1, square root of 4. Square root ng 1 ay 1. Square root ng 4 ay 2. So, A now is equal to 1/2. This is now our answer. Okay, so, pag-aralan maigi ang Pythagorean theorem, ang ginagamit siya para ma-solve or mahanap yung missing side sa kahit anong right triangle. So, gagamitin natin siya throughout the trigonometry lesson. Okay, so, again, the Pythagorean theorem states that the square of the longest side is equal to the sum of the squares of the two legs. Okay, so, susunod na lesson natin will be kinds ng, or mga types ng angles na makikita sa Cartesian plane or the rectangular coordinate system. Okay, God bless everyone. Bye.